Just like when he finished with Manchester United and Real Madrid, David Beckham ends his career at the Galaxy a champion. He is standing by right now with Monica Gonzalez.
David, how special was it for you to get a comeback victory in your last game with LA Galaxy?
It's special to get any victory in a cup final like this, you know, especially in our own home, in front of our own fans, you know.
You've spoken about potentially becoming an MLS owner. In what ways will that allow you to continue to be an ambassador for this league?
I'm going to continue. My commitment to this league and to this country and to this sport in this league will continue to be the same as what it was when I first came here 6 years ago. I might not be playing here anymore, but my commitment stays the same to growing this team, to growing this league, to growing this sport.
Thank you, David.
Thank
Best
you
of luck
much.
To you.
Thank you.
Facing injuries, facing other issues, Monica Gonzalez covering them throughout the way. Monica?
Well, Bob, remember, it was just 1 week ago today that the U.S. team was in turmoil after the Sporting News article came out. And the one effect we do know that had on the team is it forced the U.S. players to sit down and talk. And Michael Bradley told me that perhaps the team needed to learn how to close itself off from the outside world. He said they talked about how in this last stretch the team has lost a few of their intangibles that makes the team so important. And by that, he's talking about the commitment to run for 90 minutes, the willingness to fight for each other, and the mentality that they're going to win at all costs. And he said, in a game like this, a World Cup qualifier on the road, those intangibles are non-negotiable. For more on Mexico, let's go to John Sutcliffe.
You don't need a lot of opportunities. He's had a frustrating game. Mexico's been able to frustrate Spain's best player, but he gets this one opportunity, cuts inside, past two defenders, past the third defender. And as long as he gets that strike off, yeah, it deflected off a Mexican defender, but he created that opportunity for himself. And I think that's the only way they were going to beat Richard Sanchez was off of a deflection.
That loves to get forward. She plays for the under-20 Mexican national team, Bree Campos.
And Bree Campos came back from the Mexican U-20 national team camp with a lot of confidence. That's what happens when you get to play for your national team. Come back to college and everything just seems to flow, be a little bit easier. But this is a player who's so strong offensively and defensively. She combines very well with the players around her, and she could cause a lot of problems for Texas if they're not careful with her.
Game for Texas.
Well, I talked about Gabby Zarniger. She's a very important player in winning the midfield battle. That's not just the first balls, but also the second balls. And Texas needs to use the width to be able to break the pressure. They need to get out wide. That will give them more time and space to play the ball and play the way they want to.
Speaking to Andrew McKellen, she said widening the...
He knows that soccer didn't just give him the opportunity to be famous and do what he loves. It literally saved his life. And so every time Messi scores a goal, he does this. He does the same celebration as though he's doing it for something bigger than himself.
So Monica, do you believe that Griner really isn't bothered by these comments at all?
Well, I'm glad she's saying she's not bothered by it, because that's the right response. But the truth is, it's impossible not to absorb what people say, because words have energy, and she for sure feels it. But this is what she's responding is just basically saying, I'm not going to pay attention to it.
Hi, and welcome to the latest edition of World Cup Confidential. I'm Monica Gonzalez, here with two women who need no introduction. So we'll get right into the big question. Mia, how's my hair?
Looks great.
You sure?
Please, looks nice.
Okay.
A lot of products.
I want to get into a little
that's
bit more detail. Your hair is always
thank
perfect.
You,
that's why you got a pert deal.
That's right.
Was it Pantene?
No, it's pert. Pert.
So what do you guys feel about this team chemistry issue? How important is that? Do you absolutely have to have it to win a World Cup?
Go ahead. I think it's important. I think, you know, when I look at the teams that were successful.
Well, there you go. There's the inside scoop. World Cup Confidential exclusively on ESPNW.
With good hair. On
el testimonio de nuestra compañera Mónica González. Mónica, bienvenida a nuestra transmisión.
Pues la verdad, el partido hasta el momento está yendo completamente para Seattle. Es exactamente como querían jugar, con un ritmo muy, muy rápido. Y creo que Los Ángeles estaba esperando más balonazos de parte de Seattle. Y no está pasando. Seattle está jugando muy rápido y eso es exactamente lo que ellos querían. Leo Persovic. Hablé con él y me dijo que lo que hicieron bien el primer tiempo fue que encontraron a Oduro muy bien. Tienen que seguir haciendo eso. y lo que tienen que hacer mejor es en transición, que algunas veces se encontraron fuera de lugar, o sea, fuera de posición cuando perdieron la pelota, entonces tienen que mejorar en eso.
What are your impressions of the city?
Me gusta cada vez más, estoy muy contento de vivir aquí en la Gran Manzana.
There were two events towards the end of the year that caused a lot of drama. In the last game that you played in against the LA Galaxy, after the final whistle, describe what you were going through, what happened in that event.
Los Estados Unidos controlan su destino y pasan a la siguiente ronda con un empate o una victoria mañana contra Guatemala. El plan de Jürgen Klinsmann es sencillo. Queremos ganar, dijo en la conferencia de prensa. Y para poder hacer eso, tenemos que atacar, tenemos que mandar jugadores adelante. Conocen perfecto el estilo de Guatemala. Van a buscar balonazos y van a buscar la falta fuera del área. Para poder ganar, Estados Unidos tiene que mantener posición en media cancha y tener muchísima inteligencia defensivamente afuera de su área.